Another important theory in electromagnetics which will be useful in our study for microwave circuits is Emmer's theory. Effectively, Emmer's theory is discussed in the book Microwave Engineering by Dozar in some complicated way. So I'm going to blow up the explanation of Emmer's theory from the book of Engineering Electromagnetics by Hale. The potential due to electric dipole. Electric dipole is composed of two equal charges, positive Q and negative Q, and separated by distance d. And the potential due to this configuration, which is the electric dipole, at any point r is given by V equals Q multiplied by D cosine theta over 4 pi epsilon r squared. So the potential at theta equal 90 degrees, where theta is the angle from the z-axis, the potential at theta equal 90 degrees is 0. So the xy plane in this case is equipotential surface which has a potential difference equal 0. Effectively, this configuration can be replaced by assuming that we have such dipole and we inserted an equipotential surface of potential equal 0 at the center space or at the mid distance between the two charges, positive Q and negative Q. So if we have inserted an equipotential surface with a potential equal 0 at the middle between the two charges, we have the same result. The equipotential is 0. Now, if we replace this equipotential surface by a conducting medium, and we enforce it, this conducting medium to have a potential equal 0. So, inside the conducting medium, the electric field and magnetic field is 0. But from the point of view of the first charge, positive Q, we have the same potential at every point on the interface of the XY plane. So the total potential at any point above the interface Z equals 0 would be the same. It means that if I have a positive charge, positive Q, above a conducting plane, which is equipotential plane, we will have the same effect as if we have two equal charges with negative signs, positive Q and negative Q, and the distance from charge positive Q to the interface is the same as the distance from negative Q to the equipotential surface plane. And the distance here, it means that the normal distance. Alright? So, effectively, from electrical point of view, this configuration is equivalent to this configuration. Or, in other words, we can replace the conducting plane or the equipotential plane by an image charge. And this image charge has a negative value of the original charge, and at a distance from the surface is the same as the original charge. This is what we are calling Emmer's theory or method of Emmer. Effectively, this is equivalent in light to a mirror. For example, if you have a candle or a light source in front of a mirror, so it is equivalent to two sources وزود ضمير. The question now, if this electric charge is moving horizontally. So if this electric charge is positive and moving horizontally, it means that there is electric current in the direction of the motion of this positive electric charge. Now, if this electric charge is moving horizontally, its image, it will be moving horizontally too. But the image is negative charge. So if the negative charge is moving in positive x direction, it means that we have equivalent current moving in negative x direction. So in terms of electric current, if I have electric current moving in positive direction in front of a conducting plane, it is equivalent to use two current sources, one positive, the original, and its image with negative current. And this image is located at a distance minus d, where d is the distance of the original source from the conducting plane. So in the case of a problem that I have a conducting plane, and in front of the conducting plane I have a parallel electric current source, I can replace this problem by two anti-parallel current sources, because this is tangential, anti-parallel current sources, one J and one minus J, one located at the distance D and one is located at minus D, and the field due to this combination of the source and its image is the same as the field from this source with this ground plane. This is what is known as the image theory, and effectively this is the image theory for tangential electric current. If I'm talking about normal electric current, what will be the situation? Let us go back to the point source. Assuming that this is a point source and we are moving this point source in the vertical direction, for example in positive z, so we have electric current in positive z. Now its image is going to be moving in the negative z, but because the charge here is negative, the equivalent electric current, it would be moving in positive Z2. So in the case of normal electric current in front of a perfect electric conductor, it can be replaced by the original current plus its image, which will be at the same direction. So in the case of parallel electric current to a perfect conductor, it can be replaced by the original current plus its image, which is anti-parallel. In the case of normal electric current, it can be replaced by the original current plus its image, which is in the same direction. And effectively, the center of the current here has the same distance from the center of the current here. Okay? What will be the situation if I'm talking about magnetic current source? In the case of magnetic current source, if there is a magnetic current source parallel to perfect electric conductor interface, I can replace this combination by the original current plus its image. In this case, the image of the parallel magnetic current would be at the same direction of the original current, and its distance from the interface would be the same. On the other hand, the normal component of the magnetic current to a perfect electric conductor interface, it can be replaced by a normal magnetic current plus its image, which is in the negative direction of the original magnetic current. So the image of the normal component of the magnetic current to be in the opposite direction to the original normal component of the magnetic current. So this is known as the Amish theory for the magnetic current sources. Effectively, this magnetic current sources is quite useful for solving the problem of sources inside waveguides, for example, when it is surrounded by perfectly conductor, what will be the situation? We will find that by multiple images, it will be represented as an infinite array of these sources. And these have very important application, especially, for example, in solving infinite array structure and other structure related to a source in front of a perfect electric conducting medium. Okay, so this is the image theory. By the end of the image theory, we have completed chapter 1 in the book Microwave Engineering by Buzar. Starting from the next video, we are going to start with chapter 2 of the transmission line. Right? Effectively, chapter 1 in Microwave Engineering by Buzar represents the basics for electromagnetic theory, which will be used along all this book. So please be sure that the material in chapter 1 is well understood for you, because everything in the following chapter is mainly based on the basics of electromagnetics presented here in chapter 1. Okay? All right.